graduating class. Yeah, I'm on the rise, giving you the world through my own eyes. All we got is family in this world. Could be your closest friend to backstab you in this world. I'm one for the struggle, two for the come up. Ace the boy wonder, I'ma rise and grind.
Kiara and I are here to provide the land acknowledgement for the class of 2020.
We would like to give a special shout out to all of the Native graduates throughout Portland Public Schools. Portland Public Schools is located within the city of Portland, Oregon in Multnomah County. As graduates of Portland Public's class of 2020, it's essential that we acknowledge that every school building, court, field, stadium, office, local field trip, and learning space we've utilized during the many years of our learning journey has taken place on Indigenous land. As such, we honor the tribal people whose way of life, traditions, culture, and in every sense, ways of being was taken from them. Acknowledgement is a simple, powerful way of showing respect for those whose land we are on and step toward correcting the stories and practices, language and art that erase Indigenous people's history and culture, and toward inviting and honoring the truth and relationship with our Indigenous land, resources, and communities. Indigenous people have lived here since time immemorial for thousands of years in the past. The Portland metropolitan area covers both sides of the Columbia River and both sides of the Willamette River, spanning into surrounding counties. In this broad area, there were numerous tribes, peoples, and villages that honored the abundant abundance that the lands offered. We honor their history and acknowledge the sacrifices they made.
In the Portland metropolitan area, the tribes are the Multnomah, which is a band of the Chinook, the Wasco, Cowlitz, Klamath, Clackamas, Tualatin, Kalapuya, Malawa, and many other tribes who made their homes along the Columbia and Willamette River. Let us also acknowledge the robust present-day federally recognized tribes of this area, the Grand Ronde, Siletz, and Cowlitz. It is within the Confederated Tribes of Grand Ronde and the Confederated Tribes of Siletz Indians that many of the families of the bands just listed now reside. In addition, we would like to acknowledge the Chinook Nation, which has been seeking federal recognition for many years. The urban Indian community is made up of tribal diversity that originates from around the country, representing at least 380 tribes, with more than 100 tribes represented among Portland Public Schools students and families. Native students show resilience in school from the age of 3 when they enter preschool or PPS Native Montessori through high school graduation. The urban Indian community has a vivid history and present-day presence made up of people whose journeys have brought them to Portland through which ways of forced displacement or seeking better opportunities. Today, these tribes and communities celebrate their heritage, showing resilience and tenacity, which would be greatly admired by their ancestors.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting. Still there, oh say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Hello, Benson Tech graduates. This is Principal Wilson, and as I sit in my office in my cap and gown, well, in this case, in my gown, I can't help but sit back and reflect about this year and how things have changed so much over the last few months. And I keep asking myself, What if? What if we were still in school? What if there was no pandemic? What if there wasn't racial unrest happening throughout our society right now? What if we could all learn to love, support, and work with each other on a daily basis? I know this is not how we expected your senior year to come to an end so abruptly, but alas, on March 13th, that signified the last full day that we were in the school together. This is our new reality, and you have been thrust right into the center of it. I know that you are all a resilient group of individuals, and you have grown up so much over the last 4 years, but I can't stop asking myself, what if? As I stated earlier in the senior video to you all, please do not let this pandemic define your senior year of high school. Is it ideal? Of course it isn't. But I guarantee you that your senior year for the class of 2020 will not soon be forgotten. 10, 20, and even 30 years from now, you will always have something to talk about at your gatherings and reunions, as this has truly been a historical event happening at this time. I am so proud of all the graduates of Benson Tech. From the time that you walked into this building in the fall of 2016 to the online distance learning that you embarked upon in the spring of 2020. You are a fantastic group of individuals and will sorely be missed. We will miss your smiles, your laughter, your hugs, your handshakes, and your vibrant attitudes and energy that permeated throughout this building. Think about the journey that it took for you to get to this point of being a high school senior, and always reflect upon that journey. For some of you, the journey was long and treacherous, but you persevered. The journey could have been something like an endless loop of getting up early every morning to catch a bus for an hour, hour and a half, or even 2 hours just to get to Benson Tech. Then once you get here, you have to navigate the complexities of the hallways and your friends to make it through your 4 classes for that day. And then don't forget about the extracurricular activities that you would be doing after school, only to have to get back on another bus and take that journey back home, and then hit the reset button and do it all again the next day. You are a resilient group of individuals, and you are my champion. What will the next chapter of your life bring forth? No one knows, but I have an idea that you may know. And I would encourage you to always pursue your passion and dreams, and never let anyone dictate those to you. Do not be defined by someone else's expectations for you, and lead by example. Choose your destiny and be sure to leave your mark on this world. No matter what happens, you can be the change agent. And don't ever sit around and ask yourself, what if? With that being said, congratulations to the class of 2020. The Benson Tech community loves you, respects you, and we wish you nothing but the best as you embark on your new journey. Take care, and do not forget that as a Benson Tech alumnus, we will always be united by spirit and bonded by name. Thank you so much. Be safe. And as always, go Tech.
This is Guadalupe Guerrero, and as superintendent of the Portland Public Schools, I want to extend to the class of 2020 a hearty congratulations on your graduation. We are so proud of you, and you should be really proud of yourselves for reaching this important milestone, and also because we know it has taken a lot of hard work to get to this point. As an educator, I know that this moment is likely made possible because of a lot of individuals who have stood by you growing up and have been there to support you during your academic career. Graduations are a key moment for celebrating and reflecting on your successes and growths. You may be thinking about the long nights you may have spent completing an assignment, or cramming for a test, or the countless hours working with your classmates preparing a science project, or the high school musical. Or perhaps you're thinking about the time you spent on the field or on the court practicing for the big matches. Or maybe you're thinking about the homecoming dance you went to with your first crush, or the friends you've made over the years who have propped you up and provided a shoulder during those trying moments. You've each had a unique experience in arriving at this point. It is a celebration of all you've grown and the journey you've taken to get here. And for some of you, that journey has been a testament of your resilience and perseverance. I see you. Your teachers, aunties, abuelas, parents, cousins, mentors, coaches, friends, and others see you too. All of our graduates have shown resilience and adaptability as lifelong learners during this unprecedented health crisis. Given this pandemic, I want to acknowledge that you didn't have the senior year that you imagined. The PPS graduate portrait describes students prepared to lead change in the world. You've shown a commendable level of self-agency and leadership. Our community describes in our vision for the school system that we should aim to produce graduates that are inclusive, collaborative problem solvers, transformative racial equity leaders, influential global stewards, and optimistic future-oriented graduates. The class of 2020 has demonstrated many of these traits. It's had more than just a pandemic to confront. You have used your voice, your advocacy, and leadership to speak out and act on a range of important issues of our time, both those local and global. You have advocated and marched, testified at board meetings, spoken truth to power, and insisted that we need to act now on preserving your future in your advocacy for climate justice. Climate change is real and we must do better. Portland showed up strong in the youth-led movement, and it's resulted in real changes for how we make sure that every student understands this important topic. And as our country and our city confronts its history and its institutionalized systems of oppression, once again, you have continued to march and speak out against bigotry and racism. You have understood that this is a time for reflection, learning, and action. You have been clear in your declarations that Black Lives Matter. Having witnessed your leadership, I am hopeful that we will live in a more socially just world. To prepare graduates to lead change and improve the world. That's our vision for our graduates, and I believe that what future Portlanders will read about in history books, it's just that, that you are the generation truly prepared to lead meaningful change and improve the world so that children and youth from all unique and diverse backgrounds have the equitable opportunity to thrive. So as you go on to the next leg of your journey, rely on what you've learned, both about the world around you and also what you've learned about yourself. Be true to your sense of self-agency and moral compass. Pursue your emerging passions and continue to cultivate your gifts and talents. We are so very proud of you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Is a quote from an actor that I like, Brennan Lee Mulligan, where he says, "In the same way that your heart feels and your mind thinks, you, mortal beings, are the instrument by which the universe cares. If you choose to care, then the universe cares. And if you don't, then it doesn't." I love that quote. I feel like it's a reminder that even though sometimes the world seems cruel or unfeeling, that is all the more reason to care for yourself, for those around you, and for the people who come after you. It is a weird time to be moving out into the world, and there is going to be a lot that we can't control. But what we can do is choose to care. And I hope that we all do. Happy graduation.
Benson Class of 2020, although we are living in a time of uncertainty, and as much as I wish to see you all in person, I want to leave you today with a message about home. When you look at a home from the outside, it's just a house or a building. But once you step inside and make that place your home, it becomes a place where you can laugh, learn, and grow. Together, we've made a home at Benson by sharing both our struggles and accomplishments over the past 4 years. From doing mile runs in our orange gym clothes to setting up our annual tech show, it became something we all had in common. And in each major, we are a family. Together, we are a community buzzing with diverse assets and knowledge. When we held walkouts and protests with megaphones and signs declaring honor the bond, it is because our class is a class of resilience. No matter what happens, home will always be here. Benson will always stand strong. I'm so proud of us. Despite the challenges, we still have passion and dreams at our century-old school. Therefore, we embraced our struggles in order to free ourselves. Because this is where we have made our home, and we are willing to fight for it. I will miss you all, Benson Polytechnic Class of 2020. In the words of Mr. Wilson, go Tech!
We are flexible, resilient, creative, strong. Congratulations, Benson Class of 2020.
By the end of my junior year, I told myself, Tiana, you're going to take it easy next year. 4 AP classes, 2 HOSA gold medals, and 1 tear-filled senior year later, I realized that easy and me was an impossible combination. I flung myself into studying, agonizing over grades, and feeling utter despair getting up to go to school every morning. Sentiments I know many of you could relate to. Now, as I look back with pride at accomplishing one of the most difficult years I've had, I realize that this is only the end of the beginning, and there will be many struggles ahead. Thank you to teachers who have guided us, family and friends who have supported us, and obstacles that has allowed us to flourish into better versions of ourselves. Even though none of us expected our senior year to end this way, here we are celebrating an important milestone in all our lives. I know Class of 2020 is resilient, and we will be able to overcome this hurdle. We will find opportunities regardless of the situations we find ourselves in, and ultimately we will work to make ourselves and the world we live in a better place.
Congratulations to the Class of 2020. I am Tanya Melde, Benson Polytechnic Vice Principal. Today, I would like to recognize some of the outstanding students in our graduating Class of 2020. We have an amazing class of talented students being recognized for their accomplishments and particularly for their scholarly achievements. The Class of 2020 was awarded over $5 million in scholarship monies, full tuition awards, and financial aid. These come from various sources, including public and private organizations and donors, as well as other scholarships that are full rides or recurring tuition. A plethora of prestigious scholarships and grants were awarded to several deserving seniors. Our very own valedictorian, Tina Truong, had the great privilege of earning the U.S. Presidential Scholar, one of 161 students in our nation to achieve this honor. While the entire list of scholarships are too many to mention today, the insert in the commencement program denotes students who have opted to self-report and share their awards with us today. Some of these scholarships include the Simon Benson Memorial Scholarship, the Benson Alumni Scholarship, the School Board Scholarship, and many others indicated on the insert. Students also won the Quest Bridge Scholarship, Act 6 Scholarships, U of O Presidential Scholarship, the Wabzi Scholarship, the Kaiser Permanente Scholarship, and the Oregon Promise Grant, to name a few. Please take a moment to recognize the incredible talent of our Benson High School students. We are so incredibly proud of the Class of 2020's accomplishments. Good luck and take care.
I wish you all a huge success. Stay healthy, stay safe.
City.
I'm coming home again. Do you think about me now and then?
Yeah.
Do you think about me now and then? 'Cause I'm coming home again.
Oh, day.
Thank you.
say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations.
Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made it. Now we made it.
Benson Class of 2020. Today is the first day of the rest of your life. So let me just leave you with a quote from a famous radio disc jockey who once said, keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for the stars. Congratulations and keep in touch.
Benson, class of 2020, you made it. Huge and major congratulations to you. I love you all. I'll miss you dearly. And a little piece of advice, making your bed every day will really help you feel like a grown up.
Hey, class of 2020, what a weird way to end the school year, huh? It's like when I saw The Lion King in New York, and all the main characters were just wearing black t-shirts and black pants because their costumes had been destroyed the night before when the sprinklers went off in the storage room. It's not really what we were expecting, but it's kind of unique, and it'll be a good story to tell when we're all looking back on this someday in the future. Anyway, I'll miss you. Best of luck in all your future endeavors.
Congratulations on your special day. Thank you for allowing me to be part of this year. This year has been horrible, but it's also been wonderful because I've been able to see some of you go through enormous personal challenges and still rise to success, still work incredibly hard to make graduation happen. I've been honored to see it. To see students work so hard gives me hope. It gives me hope that students who can find success despite difficult circumstances are the ones we need. Those of you who can find success in this garbage pile that is 2020 so far, you are the ones this world needs. This world needs people who can change things, people who can find success in difficult times. And finding success in difficult times is what you did.
Hey, Benson Polytechnic, class of 2020, the automotive department wishes you a great rest of the year. And I'd personally like to invite you back 2021 in April to the 100th tech show. We won't be able to do it with you, but we'd sure love to have you with us for next year. Looking forward to seeing you. Take care.
Gracias por la oportunidad poder conocerles, aunque sea poquito tiempo, había sido un gusto. Les admiro muchísimo y sé que van a tener mucho éxito en cualquier cosa que sueñen hacer. Pues estaré pensando en ustedes. Muchas gracias.
Happy graduation, my peeps. Yes, you've been robbed. And we've been robbed too. We didn't get to see you all dressed up all fancy, hanging with your friends at prom. And we don't get to be with you, seeing your family celebrate this huge accomplishment that you've done. But I know that you're gonna be successful in whatever you do because you are a wonderful group of young people. It's been an honor to be your teacher. Keep being flexible, keep developing your skills, and stay safe and vote. Love you all.
Yeah, our souls are brought together so that we could love each other, brother.
2020. You are complicated, you are puzzling, but you are really strong, which is really what the world needs right now. So go out and live your life. Do stupid things, but only sort of stupid things. Come back and visit and know that you will be remembered. Bye.
I want to give a very special thank you to any of the seniors who ever took a Tech Geo student under their wing, helped them learn how to build, gave them some pointers down on the build site. A very special shout out to our little crew of seniors who hung out with us in room 229 like every day and gave us such a precious sense of community up there. And a deep appreciation for the seniors who are part of the GSA Club and any of the gay or queer or trans seniors that we have at Benson. I hope you know that younger queer students really look up to you, and so do I.
Hey seniors, congratulations on making it through. And of course, you have had a much more difficult road of it even in just the last 6 months than any other previous senior class. So please, please congratulate yourselves and take pride in the fact that you are now high school graduates. Congratulations again, and I'm so sorry that we can't all be together to celebrate you, but hopefully we'll be able to do that at some point. Bye.
I'm sorry that I'm not able to see you at a graduation and cheer you on, but you still are doing great and will have a great next year with whatever you do. So congratulations.
Congratulations, seniors, on reaching this huge milestone in your lives. The class of 2020 is full of incredible people who are ready to get out there and change the world. But remember that this is just the beginning. You should always continue your education. Never stop learning as long as you live. But for today, celebrate yourselves and what you've achieved. Go Tech.
Hello, class of 2020. Ellie up here in outer space, wishing you the best. Congratulations on all your accomplishments. We miss you. We wish we could celebrate with you and are excited to do that sometime in the future. Please stay engaged. Please keep fighting for what you believe in. And please be in contact, in communication. I have loved being in conversation with all of you who I have had the joy of teaching these past few years. I miss you, I love you, and I see you. Congratulations, y'all.
Why am I wearing sunglasses? No, it's not to look stupid. It's because the future's so bright. With you guys moving up, it's like the cavalry's coming. So keep trying to find your power. Apply it in the places that will help us get out of this mess and come back and visit. Tech family forever. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Very special princess is Rosalina Chippen.
Seniors, I wish you the best of luck. Keep your heads up and fight the good fight. Well done.
What's up, seniors, class of 2020? It's Mrs. Kenny Brew here, Mrs. KB. I just want to say congratulations. I'm super proud of you. Go get your ham. Don't play small. It will not serve the world. I love you. I'm proud of you. And I'm always here for you.
Hi, class of 2020. Thank you so much for spending your last 4 years with us at Benson Tech. It has been my absolute pleasure to work with you, whether it was in a math class, a science class, an English class, or in my own academic support classroom. I couldn't be more proud of your accomplishments, and I wish you only the best in the future.
Congratulations, Benson class of 2020. I know Benson has given you the tools for success in your future, so use them wisely.
Congratulations, class of 2020, on making it to a huge milestone with an ending that none of you deserved, but I see you out there making the best of it, And I just wanted to say good luck. I'm really proud of you. Benson was lucky to have the class of 2020. I feel lucky to have gotten to know you, and I can't wait to see everything you accomplish. I miss you. I care about you. Check in once in a while. Congratulations.
Congratulations, seniors. You did it. I'm proud of you. I know the world looks a lot different coming out of high school than it did when you went in. That's why it's so important to make sure that you take care of your health and you stay strong so that you can handle anything this world's gonna throw at you. But keep it simple. Drink lots of water, eat healthy food, make good choices. And the rest is up to you. Good luck.
Hey, Benson graduating class of 2020. Just wanna say congratulations to you for graduating and then also just persevering in the last few months here. As a mom of a 2020 graduate myself, I can empathize and feel some of the loss that you felt in having your year end so strangely. But the good news is that you're part of a very special club in history, and so one that you won't forget. And hopefully you'll have a lot of good stories to talk about in the future and some life lessons as well. But congratulations to you, best of luck, and hopefully we can catch up and see you around campus sometime soon.
We gon' walk it out and
hey seniors, I'm Benson. We are so happy for this milestone in your life and for all of your accomplishments. It's been a joy to know you, to work with each one of you. I wish you all the best for an amazing future.
Start again.